بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على إمام الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. All praises are due to Allah, and peace and blessing be upon His Messenger, His servant Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, and his family and his companions, and on those who follow his sunnah righteously till the day of judgment. May Allah answer our call. Ameen. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We will start today the tafsir of Surah Al-Ghashiyah, the chapter of Al-Ghashiyah, that is chapter 88. This is in part 30 of the Quran. My references of the Tafsir Ibn Kathir, the abridged Tafsir, and that is by a group of scholars under the supervision of Shaykh Safiur Rahman Al-Mubarakuri, and also the Arabic books of Tafsir, Safwat al-Tafasir, the summary of all Tafsirs by Muhammad Ali al-Sabuni, and also the Mukhtasar Ibn Kathir, the summary of Ibn Kathir by Muhammad Ali al-Sabuni, and also the books of Al-Jannah wal-Nar, the paradise and the hellfire, for Dr. Umar Sulaiman Abdullah al-Ashqar, and also the book of Al-Qiyam al-Kubra, the great Qiyamah or the great hereafter, for the same Dr. Umar Sulaiman Abdullah al-Ashqar. So may Allah give us tawfiq. Now, Surah Al-Ghashiyah is Surah 88. And I will give an introduction to this surah today. This surah is Makki surah, and we have discussed in the past in the introduction of the tafsir, so I would suggest you refer to that. This Makki was revealed before the migration of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam from Mecca to Medina. And this surah has talked about two important subjects, and that's the theme of the surah. Surah Al-Ghashiyah, or the overwhelming event, that the meaning of Al-Ghashiyah, talks about, one, the hereafter, the conditions, what happened in the hereafter, and specifically talk about two groups, the disbelievers, and describe them, and describe their condition, describe how they look, and describe what they will face and where they end up and what food they eat and what drink they have. And then talk about the, on the other hand, as a comparison with the believers, what would be the comparison to the disbelievers, how they look like and where they end up and how is the condition they're going to end up in. And part of the description would be about paradise. And the second section of the surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to ponder and look at the proofs of the creation that Allah has created. Allah commands His servants to look at His creations that prove His power and greatness. He wants us to look at the animals. He wants us to look at the skies, how they erected, and at the mountains. The skies, how they're erased, and the mountains, how they're erected. The surah ends by reminding, by ordering the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to remind us, فَذَكِّرْ إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ مُذَكِّرُ. And that is the job of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is to convey the message. And Allah told us what would happen to those who reject the message and who turn away and disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will take care of them and will punish them the greatest punishment. And Allah would end up with the last two verses, that those, they will come to us. They're returning nowhere but to us. Inna ilayna iyabahum. And at that time, for us will be their reckoning. This is the summary of Surah Al-Ghashiyah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to benefit us from the teaching of the Quran and from the teaching of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Subhanaka Rabbana wa bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.